So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie V is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Texas Longhorns and the Butler Bulldogs.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Bulldogs might be in over their heads in this one, Dick.
Absolutely. Here are some things that they have to do if they're going to have a chance to win. First, play your game. It's up to the point guard to make certain that they stay in their game and they play at their pace. Next, hey, disrupt the rhythm of their outside shooters. Don't let them just catch the ball and shoot. Get right up on them. Lastly, make good decisions with the rock. Don't turn it over, baby.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Controlling the ball.
Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. He bombs from outside. Drains the shot. He may be in trouble here. On the outside. 10 on the shot clock. Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Trying to feed the low block. Entry pass in the paint. Good fake. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
The power forward takes the pass. Number 5, pump fakes. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He shows the sweet touch. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Number 4 is eager and excited to compete.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. He wants a 3, knocks it down. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. We're going to move it around the perimeter. Puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. He fakes the shot, and the ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Well, the defender goes down, but there's no call either way.
Wow, no call right there. I think that was a good call, though, by the official.
Looking for a good shot. 10 on the shot clock. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Down inside. Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby. It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
They go into the low block. Here's the drop step in the low block.
Oh, he does a great job using his footwork to get over the top of the defensive player.
That's an 8-zip run.
Now trying to feed the low block. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Tries for 2. In and out. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
for the bucket. They're just having a devil of a time getting good looks at the hole.
That's right, Brad. I haven't seen a whole lot of plays carried out and executed the way they should be.
This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
On the dribble, gives it up. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
He shoots from long range. Way off target. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Fake. Fakes it. This school is known for football. It's great to see that the basketball program is now getting some of that attention.
Times are changing, though, Brad. They have been more competitive of late on the basketball court.
Number 50 gets the ball. He shoots from right of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Working it around the perimeter, in the paint. Number 24 is pounded on his way up. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
At the line. Good. Misses the second. And a big rebound.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
Both teams looking to get things going here. The center with the ball.
Great play to take that to the basket. Look at that spacing. There's the screen up on top.
He shoots from the baseline. The Longhorns have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple. Dump it inside.
Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
Number 32 gets the pass. With the fake. With the jump hook. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
They're working around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the key. Way off target.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Too fancy, too much mustard there, baby.
Here's a nice face up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket.
He makes the block.
He went up and knocked it away.
They'll work it around the arc. High post flasher is open. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Looking for a good shot. The point guard takes the feed. He looks at the hoop. Fires away.
They're having a rough time getting it on the drop, Brad. They should take it to the basket and get some easy hoops.
This is just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
stolen. Number 24 is called for the foul. First team foul. Those are the types of plays you want a lot of. These kids are on a roll. Look at them celebrating with one another.
I'd celebrate too, partner. They are playing some great basketball at the moment. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Nice high post screen.
He launches a three. Off the rim and no good. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. But good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
In the paint. The fake. Tries to turn. The defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
At the end of the first half, the Longhorns trail by 9. It's a close one, folks. What have you got, Dick, as your play of the half?
Play of the half? Buzzer beater, baby. You gotta love it.
Well, it looks like the teams are just about set for the second half. Let's get back to the action. Butler gave us a three-ball lesson, Dick, in that first half.
I'll tell you, a mighty lesson it was. I expect to see more of the same in the second half.
Check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. The ball goes out of bounds. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
Dumps it in. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Time to pick up the defense here now. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
He takes the shot from the baseline. He gets another one to go.
This is a shooting clinic, my friend.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Looking for the foul. Number 14 with a finger roll. Takes the pass in the paint. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork, really.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He intercepts it. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Number 9, 14.
Nice fake.
There's a double team waiting there. For the bucket. And in and out.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
And he missed. Moving it around the perimeter. Sets a screen for his teammate. The Longhorns have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
On the outside. Puts it up, looking for contact.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Strips the ball. The power forward receives the ball. Goes up for two. The layup.
Nothing gonna come easy tonight, baby.
They are really playing for keeps. The center receives the pass. Let's it fly. The Bulldogs have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
For two. Can't get the shot to go. Comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down on the low block.
Very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Collision there, but no foul called there.
I think good call by the official. Not blowing the whistle. I think it's an excellent call.
The fake. The small forward handles the pass. Rims out. The Longhorns have been receiving that additional attention due to their recent success.
Last time I checked, recent success was a good thing. As a matter of fact, any success is a good thing.
From left of the circle.
He missed the jumper off the nice screen.
Intercepted. Tries for two. Butler has put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
The ball goes out of play. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Thanks, Aaron. He shoots from the top of the circle, way off target. On the dribble, gives it up. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He gets the rebound. Great defense. Down he goes, and no foul call either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
gave it up. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
On the dribble, gives it up. Steals the pass.
Look at that spacing.
Here's a double team. Takes the shot. Off the rim and no good. In the paint.
He could make the easy inside hoop off the screen. I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Makes the second shot. And the ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
High post player flashing. He pump fakes. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
The power forward handles the feed. Gave it up. And the ball goes out of play. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. For two, Butler are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
In the paint.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul. There.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
Pump him up then, young man. He wants everyone on their feet.
He's feeling good, Brad. He's feeling really good.
Picks off the lazy pass. He goes for three. Good.
Definitely worth another look, Brad.
Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout. A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
He drains the bucket. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him, and I'd see what happens.
Looking for a good shot. Watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays it where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out, and that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
Number 24 takes it away. One timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break. We go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
All right, thanks, Aaron. I get a feeling they've changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
Fake. He shoots from the angle.
They have to foul to send them to the line and hope they miss.
Shot clock is dead. They might have walked right into certain defeat with that turnover, Dick.
You're right, Brad. Plays like that seal fates in games like this.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ballgame.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
Second shot, good. Tight defense forces a 5-second call.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
Number 10 to the line for the 1-1. Makes the front end of the 1-1. It's good.
This is where you really need a bucket to have a chance.
See who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. He tries to beat the clock. He doesn't get the hoop. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Butler came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.